As the use of artificial intelligence continues to grow in the classroom, educators are now split on the new technology's benefits. According to a new Pew Research survey, 25% of teachers in America think AI does more harm than good for the students. Our next guest, however, thinks AI is the future of education. Let's bring in right now the founder and CEO of the nonprofit educational organization Khan Academy, Sal Khan. He's the author of the new book, Brave New Words, How AI Will Revolutionize Education and Why That's a Good Thing. Sal, we just had a segment talking about the pitfalls of AI. Give us reason to hope that this really could lead to a more positive, brave new world.
Yeah, and the reality is everything you just showed in that last segment is real, though no pun intended. But right. the reality is there are some positive things. And in education, obviously when ChatGPT came out, everyone's like, oh, kids are going to cheat. And they are going to cheat, and they are cheating. But the reality is ChatGPT wasn't built for education. And so it was a very thin layer on top of these large language models. But as I write in the book, there are ways to use the same underlying technology to really support teachers and really support students. I started Khan Academy almost 20 years ago, tutoring family. I used to be an analyst at a hedge fund, and I was tutoring family. Word spreads that free tutoring is going on. It became more family. And I started really trying to scale up what I was able to do in one-on-one tutoring. And I did it with videos. I did it with software. But you can only go so far with that. But then when we started to see what was possible in the last couple of years with some of these frontier AI models, it starts to get really close in certain ways to what I was able to do with my cousins. And so our goal is, hey, that's a positive use case. And it can also support teachers, help them with lesson planning, help them write progress reports, even do a preliminary grade. A teacher should be in charge at the end of that. And then you can actually get some real net benefit out of it.
Well, what you've done with Khan Academy has really revolutionized and democratized education to some extent, because your education modules are accessible in most countries in the entire world. So how now does AI really impact the product that you're able to put out into the world? What's the most positive thing?
Yeah, so our mission as a nonprofit is free, world-class education for anyone, anywhere. And I tell our team, there's many ways that you could try to do that. You could lobby governments to spend more on education or things like that. Our vehicle has always been, hey, there's these scalable technologies that, used appropriately, could actually get more personalization if kids hopefully do have access to school. But if you're in parts of the world that don't have access to a school, or the schools don't have certain classes, we want to raise the floor there. And what AI does is, you know, people say, oh, on-demand video is great, Sal, but what happens when a student wants to ask a question? Or now kids are cheating with AI. How do you solve that? Well, what if the students, if the AI supported the student, but that AI is connected to the teacher? So that AI can report to the teacher what they did with the student, and they can tell the teacher the entire process. And so when you take these technologies and you put them on something, they're not free, because it's very computationally intensive, but it's going to get pretty close to free. So I think it's going to make these things that can be world-class a lot more accessible.
So, Salman, how does AI help a five-year-old learn to read?
Yeah, and we haven't gotten there yet. We have an app, Khan Academy Kids. It's free. Everything I'm talking about is funded with philanthropy. But we can imagine in the next couple of years, you will see apps that a child could sound out words with. It could ask the child to write out a letter, and it will be able to recognize that letter. A child will be able to play games in the real world. Hey, why don't you build this in with blocks? And the app will say, great job. Now, I don't think that's a replacement for humans in their life. Ideally, even Khan Academy Kids, we say that's best when a parent, a sibling, a grandparent is sitting next to their child and doing it together. And even then, it should maybe be for 20, 30 minutes a day max. But that's where we're going.
Is AI at all in competition with the in-class teacher?
I don't think so. You know, the way we frame it, we have already tens of thousands of students and teachers. This coming school year is going to be hundreds of thousands. We're partnering with hundreds of school districts around the country and actually now around the world. And the first thing we tell teachers, think of, you know, how much time do you spend writing lesson plans, grading papers, writing progress reports? It's usually 10, 15 hours a week doing that type of task. I said, imagine if your school district just discovered all sorts of resources and they could hire teaching assistants for every one of you to do those types of things. And they could provide more personalized support for your students, but report back to you. And also, hold your students accountable if they try to cheat or try to cut some corners. And every teacher's like, yes, sign me up for that.
Thank you so much for being with us. The new book is titled Brave New Words, How AI is Going to Revolutionize Education, Why That's a Good Thing. It's on sale now, and just rave reviews. Bill Gates calls it a masterclass for anyone interested in the future of education. Adam Grant says the same thing. Walter Isaacson, Sam Altman, Lorraine Powell Jobs, on and on and on. Tony Blair, all saying, if you want to know about the future of education, read this book. It's on sale. Thank you so much. Greatly appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.